Good afternoon, students.
Good afternoon, sir.
So today is the last class for trigonometry. Tomorrow I am going to start matrices. So if possible, I will stop today itself. Okay. So write the problem. Show that log of tan of pi by 4 plus I x by 2 is equal to I into tan inverse of sin h x. Solution. So now I am going to solve this problem by one method. Suppose if you find any other method, okay, any other methods and simpler than this method, you can solve and post in the group, or you can send to me. I will check and then later you can post in the group. So now let us take the left hand side. What is the left hand side? Log of tan of pi by 4 plus I x by 2. So now here, first I am going to apply tan of a plus b formula. So tan a, this is tan pi by 4 plus tan b. Tan b is b is I x by 2, okay, divided by 1 minus tan a into tan b, tan pi by 4 into tan I x by 2. So this is the first step. Okay, so we applied tan of a plus b formula. The second step, tan ix. Tan ix is what? I tan hx.
Hx.
Yes. Log tan pi by 4 is 1 plus tan ix formula. I tan hx by 2 divided by 1 minus tan pi by 4 is 1 and then and then tan I x by 2 is I tan h x by 2. Okay, after writing this, now I am going to multiply its conjugate. 1 plus I tan h x by 2 divided by 1 plus I tan h x by 2. Close the bracket. Now the numerator you have 1 plus I tan h x by 2 whole square. The denominator a minus b into a plus b. Okay. So this is equal to log of 1 plus I tan h x by 2 whole square. The denominator is a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square, 1 square, a I square is minus, okay, I square is minus, so minus of minus plus, okay, tan h square x by 2, okay, please write. So now only current power came. So I'll charge it. my laptop. Now, the numerator apply the formula a plus b whole square formula, which is equal to log a square is 1 and b square. B square is what? I tan h x by 2 whole square. That is I square is minus. So minus, you can write directly minus tan h square x by 2 plus 2ab. 2ab is what? 2i tan h x by 2 denominator. Denominator is as it is 1 plus tan h square x by 2. So now I am going to write everything in terms of sine and cos. 1 minus tan h square x by 2, I am going to write sine h square x by 2 divided by cos h square x by 2 plus 2i sine h x by 2 is, sorry, tan hx by 2 is sin hx by 2 divided by cos hx by 2, okay, divided by 1 plus sin by cos, sorry, sin h square x by 2 divided by cos h square x by 2. Okay, so in the numerator, I am going to take cos h square x by 2, LCM. So if I take cos h square x by 2, here we'll get here cos h square x by 2 minus sin h square x by 2, here plus 2i sin hx by 2 into cos hx by 2. Okay, wa? Similarly, denominator, if I take cos h square x by 2, we'll get what? Cos h square x by 2 plus sin h square x by 2. After taking cos h square x by 2 LCM in the numerator and the denominator, I can cancel cos h square x by 2. So I will write the numerator log of. So can anyone tell what is the numerator?
Cos h square x by 2.
Cos h square x by 2
minus sin h square x by 2
minus sin h square x by 2
plus
plus how many
2 yes sir plus 2i sin h x by 2
2i sin
h x by 2
x by 2 into
cos h x by 2
cos h x by 2. This is a numerator. Very good. What is the denominator?
Cos h square x by 2.
Cos h square x by 2. Okay.
Plus sin h square x by 2.
Okay. Thank you, Kavimani. Good. So now, okay, I will ask you somebody. Okay, because these are the basic things. Cos h square x minus sin h square x by 2. Okay, wa? Shruti, please tell what is cos h square x by 2 minus sin h square x by 2? Okay. Because Manivasagam, Sarvesh, Santanam, Vetri Thirumahan, Rahul,
Yes, sir. One, sir.
One. Okay. So this is a simplest question. Okay, wa? Thank you, Rahul. Cos h square x minus sin h square x is 1. Okay. Okay. So, okay, Shruti. Okay, try to answer for the if possible next question, or otherwise you can try to give the answer tomorrow. Okay, now here 2 sin hx by 2 into cos hx by 2. So I will ask you, Prashant, what is Prashant Kumar? If you know, you can tell. What is 2 sin hx by 2 cos hx by 2? Okay, Srivastan. Gogol. Uddavan. Rahul Sai.
I sign HX, sir.
Yeah, this is I. Okay, wa? So what is sign HX? Sign HX is equal to 2 sin hx by 2 into what? Cos hx by 2. So I think we derived this not the same formula. Okay, wa? Sin h 2x. Is it correct, Rahul?
No, sir, I think.
Rahul, I can't hear your voice.
Hello, sir.
Is yeah, it... please. Whether we derived this formula or not, sin h2x.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's why I'm asking. What is sin h2x? Please tell. 2?
2 sin hx cos hx.
Yeah, 2 sin hx into cos hx. Okay. So here I have 2 sin hx by 2 cos hx by 2. So it should be sin hx. So again, these are the basic things. So if you don't know basic, it is very difficult to solve the problems. I think I am the only person still I am taking trigonometry. Okay, what is the cos h square x by 2 plus sin h square x by 2? Anybody?
Cos hx.
Very good for me. Cos hx. So can you tell how we got this formula cos hx? From which formula we got?
By cos hx.
Cos 2hx.
Yeah, Priyanka, please tell.
Sir, it's a derivative of cos h 2x.
Okay, cos 2x. Cos 2x is what? Please tell, what is cos 2x? What is the right hand side of cos 2x?
Cos square x plus sin square x.
Cos square x plus or wrong?
Minus.
Okay. At least you tried for this question. Okay, good. Okay. But instead of plus, we have minus. Okay. So thank you for everyone. Okay. You should know these things. So cos hx is cos h square x by 2 plus sin h square x by 2. Okay. So that's why I write the denominator is what? Cos hx. Now, one by cos hx. What is one by cos hx? Log of secant hx plus I sin hx by tan cos hx is tan hx. Okay. Now this is of the form log of x plus I y. Log of x plus I y. Logarithm of a complex number. What is log of x plus I y?
Half log x square plus y square plus I tan inverse of y by x.
Yes, correct, Pumachandra. So here x is this is x, y is tan hx. So it is equal to half log x square is taken h square x plus y square is tan h square x plus I tan inverse of b by y by x. Y by x is what, tan hx loaded by secant hx. Okay, what is secant h square x plus tan h square x?
One.
Very good. Because we derived this formula from where?
From secant square x minus tan square x.
Yeah, secant square x minus tan square x is equal to 1.
1.
Yeah. Okay, plus okay, I tan inverse of, I will write this is a sine hx divided by cos hx divided by 1 by cos hx. So log 1 is 0. What is the final answer? I into tan inverse of sine hx. Cos hx gets cancelled. I think this is the right hand side. Please check it. I tan inverse of sine hx.
Sir, I tan h inverse of sine hx. No, sir, right hand side.
I, or Misha, please write. Tan inverse on a good one.
Sorry, sir.
Okay. தப்பு பண்ணிருந்தா சொல்லுங்க, ஓகேவா, கரெக்ட் பண்ணிக்கலாம். ஓகே, ஸோ ப்ராப்ளம் நம்பர் 2, ப்ரூவ் தட் பை கன்சிடரிங் ஒன்லி த பிரின்சிபல் only the principal values of the logarithm the real part of one plus I whole power log one plus I, okay, is is 2 power 1 by 4 log 2. So everything 2 power 1 by 4 log 2 into e power minus pi square by 16 into cos of pi by 4 log 2. Actually similar type of problems I solved in the previous class. So can anyone tell what is the problem?
Sir, I power log of 1 plus I.
I power log of
1 plus I.
Okay. Yes, you are correct. So I power log of 1 plus I. Here what? 1 plus I whole power log of 1 plus I. Eva. Okay. So we will do it this problem finally if the time permits. Okay. Otherwise, this is a practice problem. First, I will finish something which is a little bit different. Okay. Next, I'll go to problem 3. Yesterday, I posted this problem in the group. I posted 3 problems. Okay. I got the answer for 2 problems. Find, separate the into real and the imaginary part of. Actually, this problem is also asked in the 2-mark question last year CA. And also, I think Yuvashree solved one problem and Harshavardhan solved one problem. Both the problems are asked in the 2-mark questions. Okay. So maybe that is a little bit lengthy, but still it is a 2-mark question. So it should be ready. Okay. So you can't climb. Okay, sir, it's very lengthy. How I can do? So you need to do it. You should do it. Okay. So separate into real and imaginary parts of root 3 plus I whole power root 3 minus I divided by root 3 minus I whole power root 3 plus I. So the main reason why they are asking a little bit tough problem means the main reason is, suppose if they ask the same problem which we taught in the classroom, most of the students will write from the class notes. Okay, so to avoid copying, our university is suggested that most of the problems should be, even 100% of the problem should not be solved. The same problem should not be solved in the classroom. So those types of problems should be asked in the CA. But the method ideas are similar. Okay, so it will not go in out of the syllabus. Okay, so that is the idea. Suppose if you come here, if you write offline, then the question paper is different. So which is equal to, we can write e power log root 3 plus I whole power root 3 minus I. So divided by e power log root 3 minus I whole power root 3 minus. So now you can write log m power n, you can write n log m. So e power root 3 sir, minus. Yes.
Sir, in the denominator you have written it as 3 root 3 power minus I, sir. Root 3 plus I.
Root 3 plus I. Yes, correct. Correct. What is your name?
Sir,
Kripa Arjun. Okay. Thank you, Kripa Arjun. Okay. This is e power root 3 minus I log root 3 plus I divided by e power root 3 plus I. Okay, root 3 plus I into what? Log of root 3 minus. Okay. So now I just I'll give you the idea. I think this is of the form log of x plus iy. Okay, this is here also you have log of x plus iy. So you should apply 1 by 2 log of x square plus y square plus I tan inverse of b by a. Here also you can use 1 by 2. Instead of 1 by 2, you can use what? Log of root of a square plus b square also you can use it. So can anyone tell the next step? E power root 3 minus I into group origin, please tell. Log of
3 plus
root of, instead of half, I will put root here. A square. Okay. Root 3 whole square is what?
3, sir.
3. B is 1. Na? So 1 square plus I tan inverse of B by A. 1 by
3.
Root 3. Yeah. Okay. Close the bracket. So everything, it is e power. What is the denominator? E power
root 3 plus I.
Root 3 plus I. Continue.
Into log of?
Into log of?
3 plus 1.
Root of?
Yes, sir. Root of 3 plus 1.
Root of 3 plus 1.
Plus I tan inverse of?
Plus I.
Tan inverse of?
Tan inverse of?
Minus 1 by root 3.
Minus 1 by root 3. Yes, correct. Purnachandran. So now this is equal to e power root 3 minus I. So this is in log root 4. Log root 4 is log 2. Plus I tan inverse of 1 by root 3 is what? Pi by 6.
Tan 30 degree.
Yeah. 30 is pi by 6 divided by e power root 3 plus I into log root 4, that is log 2, tan inverse of minus x is minus tan inverse of x, so minus I tan inverse of 1 by root 3 is what? Again pi by 6. Okay, so now multiply root 3 root 3 minus I into this term, similarly root 3 plus I into this term. Actually this is the power, okay, this should be in the power, log 2 minus I pi by 6. So now I'm going to write e power root 3 into log 2, okay, my plus I
root 3 pi by 6.
Root 3 pi by 6, okay,
minus I log 2,
minus I log 2, okay,
plus pi by 6.
Yes, plus pi by 6. I square is minus, minus of minus plus pi by 6, okay, divided by e power root 3 log 2. Minus I root 3, everything e power pi by 6 plus, this is 6.
I log 2.
I log 2, okay.
Again plus pi by 6.
Yes, again pi by 6. Thank you, Purnachandran. Now I am going to write separately these two terms separately, the terms which contains I separately. Similarly, in the denominator. So, which is equal to e power
root 3 log 2 plus
root 3 log 2, okay, plus
pi by 6.
Pi by 6, okay.
Plus I into
plus not I, e power I into.
Okay, sir.
Correct formula, sir. E
yes,
power
sir.
I. Na. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
E power I into
root 3
root 3 pi by 6
minus log 2.
Yes. Okay, divided by same thing, you can check it.
Yes, sir. Root 3 log 2 plus
root
pi by 6.
Root 3 log 2 plus pi by 6. Into e power
I
will take I, minus I commonly.
Minus I, sir.
If I take minus I, then what is remaining?
Root 3 pi by 6 minus log 2.
Yeah, the same thing.
Yes, sir.
Root 3 pi by 6. So you can cancel these two terms. So if I write in the numerator, this is also e power plus I. So you can write directly what? E power 2i. Yeah.
Yes, sir, 2i.
2i root 3 pi by 6.
Pi by 6 minus log 2.
Minus log 2. So now this is of the form e power I theta. So theta is 2 into the remaining thing. So cos of is Bhavan is here. Bhavan. Yesterday Bhavan sent this solution to B. But yes, sir. So what about you can tell, okay? But slightly he done the mistake, but I think most of the part is correct. So 2 into root 3 pi by 6. In classroom la pesama ni enga poi pesa poringa solunga enga pesanumo anga pesam. Plus cos theta plus I sine theta. Okay. So this is 2 into root 3 pi by 6 minus log 2. This is not only for Bhavan, for everybody. Okay. It's for everyone. I'm telling you. Okay. So this is the final answer. So next we will go to the next problem. Show that the function sine hx plus n into cos hx equal to k has two real roots. If k greater than root of n square minus 1. So this is the problem. Okay. We solved a similar type of problem. Yesterday also, I gave one problem, solve the equation 4 tan hx is equal to 1 plus secant hx. Okay. This problem is also comes the same idea. Okay, so you know actually for quadratic equation, okay, you have two roots. So when the two roots are it has two real roots, under what condition?
Sir, if it is equal to zero,
discriminant is what? Discriminant
greater than zero.
Greater than zero. So that you studied in the where you studied? 8th standard or 9th standard? Purnachandra?
8th, sir.
I don't know.
8th, sir.
8th, okay. Yes. So that is the basics. Okay, so already I told that. So if you are strong in the basics, then you can solve any problem. So if you don't solve the problem, means you don't know the basics. So then you should learn the basic and then try to solve the problem. Okay, I'm telling you what to do. Okay, so show that the function has two real roots if k greater than root of n square minus 1. Okay, so now what is given? Sin hx plus n into cos hx equal to k. Sin hx formula, e power x, sorry, e minus e power minus,
minus e power minus x by 2.
n into e power x plus e power minus x by 2 equal to k. So now I'm going to write this one. You can write what, 1 by e power x, then can you write like this, e power 2x minus 1 by 2 into e power x?
Because
this is 1 by e power x cross multiply, and then that e power x coming here. Okay, so plus n into, similarly how to write this one,
e power 2x plus 1 by 2e power x.
Okay, is equal to k. So now throw out to multiply by e power 2x. Okay, then you will get what, e power 2x minus 1 plus n into e power 2x plus n. So you are multiplying by e power 2x throughout. Okay, so 2k into e power x. So now collect the terms which contains e power 2x separately. So e power 2x, 1 plus n or n plus 1, minus, I will write this term, 2k into e power x. Okay, remind you have what? N minus 1, n minus 1 is a constant term. So actually this is a quadratic equation in e power x. So I will write e power x whole square into n plus 1 minus 2k into e power x plus n minus 1 equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation in e power x. Okay, so it has two real roots. Okay, or two real roots. Okay, so b square discriminant should be greater than 0. So b square minus 4ac should be greater than 0. What is b? B is minus 2k. Okay, what is a? A is n plus 1. A is n plus 1. B is minus 2k. C is n minus 1. So b square is minus 2k square minus 4a. A is what? N plus 1. C is n minus 1. It should be greater than 0. This is true if and only if. Okay, this is true if and only if 4k square minus 4 into a plus b into a minus b, that is n square, minus 1 should be greater than 0. So this is true if and only if throughout divide by 4. Okay, 4 k square minus of what? n square minus 1 is greater than 0. So this is true if and only if k square greater than n square minus 1. So if this is true, then you can say this statement is true. So and hence it has two real roots. Okay. So solution is over.
So can you explain it once again?
Which step?
From the minus 2k the whole square.
This one now.
Yes, sir.
So this is the quadratic equation in e power x. Okay. This is the quadratic equation. So this quadratic equation has two real roots. Okay, I already told that the quadratic equation has two real distinct roots, then the discriminant should be greater than zero. This b square minus 4ac should be greater than zero. So here I wrote what is a, what is b, what is c. A is n plus 1, b is minus 2k, c is n minus 1. So b square is what? Minus 2k whole square minus 4. A is n plus 1. C is n minus 1. So it should be greater than 0. So then only the roots are real and distinct.
Sir, why is that you are assuming that b square minus 4ac is greater than 0?
You studied quadratic equation or not?
Yes, sir.
The quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 has real and distinct root. When it has real and distinct root? Please tell.
Oh, okay, sir. Sorry, sir. I forgot the
rules. So you should, that I already, before starting the problem, I asked you, I think I told, whether I told or not. Please, anyone else respond?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I told that before starting the problem, I told that the discriminant should be greater than zero. And Kavimani and Purna Chandra told that, they studied in the eighth class, So, but I am ready to explain, I am ready to explain one more time, but you should ask in the proper way, So if you don't know some concept, you should ask in the polite manner, So even ever. Some of the students know very well the concepts. So they are asking very politely the questions. But you are not like this. So that's why when you are asking a question, I will harshly reply. So I will tell, because you asked the question, So this the quadratic equation has two real and distinct roots only if the discriminant delta is b square minus 4ac should be greater than 0. So please tell when it has a real and equal roots. How many?
Sir, equal to 0.
Yeah, delta equal to 0. Okay, very good. Okay, when it has a complex roots?
Less than 0.
Yeah, less than 0. Delta is less than 0. Thank you, Purna Chandra. next column, find the sum of the series. A cos square alpha minus a cube by 3 into cos square 3 alpha plus a power. Actually, this problem is also asked where? Can anyone reply? Please reply, anyone. If you know, you can tell.
CA.
CA. Which CA? Kripa Arjun. Last year, last year, yes. CA question paper. I think last time also you I think Kripa Arjun. Okay. Solve this question. But I don't expect these types of question, but this is a little bit difficult from the student point of view. I know that, but this question is asked in the previous time. Find the sum of the series. Okay, you need to find the sum of the series using this series. Okay, using this series and apply the and applying. The Grigori series. Yes, I think in the last class I derived a Grigori series. What is Grigori series? Tan inverse of A. What is tan inverse of A? So can anyone tell?
Sir, A minus A cube by 3.
A minus a by 3 is correct. Yeah.
Plus a power 5 by 5.
A power 5 by 5.
Minus and so on.
Minus 1. Okay. Correct, Kavimani. I think in the last class we derived this this one. So to derive this, we used one formula. Can anyone remember that formula? So you should interrelate like this. Then only you never forget. Okay. Well. So what is the formula you used to derive this result?
Sir, log of 1 plus x.
Yeah, USC also told that log of 1 plus x. Okay, yeah. And then log of 1 minus x, she tried, Purna Chandra told the correct answer. Okay. So, yes, log of 1 plus x, correct. And then now we will try to solve this problem. So why I am telling these things means then if I tell repeatedly, you can remember, okay? So take S. What is S? I'll take this is S, okay? This is something interesting, but a little bit difficult. So S is equal to, so A into sine square alpha. Sine square alpha, I'm going to write 1 minus cos square alpha. Minus a cube by 3 sine square 3 alpha. Sine square 3 alpha is 1 minus cos square 3 alpha. Okay. This minus dot 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 I will write here. Plus a power 5 by 5 sine square 5 alpha is 1 minus cos square phi alpha minus and dot dot. Okay. So now I'm going to write, if you multiply these two, I'll get what? A. If I multiply these two, I'll get what? Minus a cube by 3. If I multiply these two, you'll get what? A power 5 by 5. I will write that term separately. Okay. So I will write it. If you don't understand any step, please ask me. I will explain again. So a minus a cube by 3 plus a power 5 by 5 minus and so on. Okay, what is remaining? You or she, please tell. What are the remaining terms? If you know, you can tell.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Minus a cos square alpha.
Correct. Can we take minus common?
Okay, sir. Okay. Minus of a cos square alpha.
Okay.
Plus a cube.
Plus or minus? Check for me. To take minus commonly, here what?
So 1 minute previous.
Minus of minus plus. Yes, but you took minus commonly, so up and over. Yeah.
Minus, sir.
Yeah, minus a cube by 3.
A cube by 3 cos square 3 alpha.
Cos square 3 alpha, okay. And here plus, you have, you have here minus. But you took minus already, so plus, okay.
Plus a power 5 by 5.
Okay.
Cos square 5 alpha.
Okay. Thank you, Vashi.
Okay, sir.
Minus and so on. So now, Rahul. Is Rahul is here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Please tell, what is this? Tan inverse of?
Tan inverse, yes, sir.
Yes, tan inverse of A. Correct, Rahul. So I will take this expression is C, some capital C, okay, where capital C equal to A into cos square alpha minus A cube by 3 into cos square 3 alpha plus a power 5 by 5 into cos square 5 alpha minus and so on. So from this I am going to write C. What is a C? C equal to tan inverse of A minus S. I call this is equation 1. Okay, now once you know the actually what is a C? C is a cos square alpha minus a cube by 3 cos square 3 alpha plus a power 5 by cos square 5 alpha. Actually, I need to find sum of the series C. Is it correct? I need to find the sum of this series. So this is actually C. Okay. So to find C, now it is enough to find S. Once I find S, then you can substitute here, you can finish the problem. Okay. Now, we know that what is S. So this is S. Okay. So here I write in terms of 1 minus cos square alpha. Okay. Now I am going to write sine square alpha, you can write what? 1 minus cos 2 alpha by 2. Now I am going to write S is equal to. So S is equal to, okay, I'll write in the next page. So S is equal to A into sine square alpha, I'm going to write 1 minus cos 2 alpha by 2. Similarly, please tell the remaining term, Kribarjan. A cube by 3
1 minus cos 6 alpha beta.
1 minus sin square 3 alpha, how to write? 1 minus cos 6 alpha by 2 r.
Yes sir.
1 minus cos 6 alpha by 2 r plus what is the next term?
A power 5 by 5.
A power 5 by 5, okay.
Into 1 minus cos 10 alpha by 2.
Cos 10 alpha divided by 2
r. 2.
Okay, thank you, Kripa Arjun. Minus and so on. Okay, now this is equal to A by 2 minus A into cos 2 alpha divided by 2 minus A cube by 6 plus A cube into cos 6 alpha divided by 6. What is the next term? Plus A power 5 by 10 minus A power 5 into cos 10 alpha by 10 and so on. So here also I am going to collect the terms which contains A separately, the terms which contains A and cos alpha separately. Okay, so now this is equal to, I took half commonly, remaining is what? A minus A cube by 3 plus A power 5 by 5 minus and so on. Okay, remaining term also, these terms I'm going to take commonly minus 1 by 2. So if I take minus 1 by 2, what is remaining? A cos 2 alpha plus minus, here minus, okay, here, okay, minus A cube cos 6 alpha by, I took 2 commonly, 3, okay, and then here minus I took commonly, plus, yes, plus A power 5 cos 10 alpha by 5 minus dot dot, this is minus dot dot dot, and close the bracket. Okay, so again we know that this series is what? Left hand side is, yes, please tell what is this?
Grigori series, sir.
Yeah, Grigori series, that is the tan inverse of A. Thank you. Minus, what is this expression? Anybody? What is this expression? Okay, so this is the new to you, because this is C. Okay, you take this is C. Similarly, I will take this is some, I'll give some other name for this. I will give you A. Okay, I'll give A. This is equation 2, where A equal to, what is A? A cos 2 alpha minus A cube cos 6 alpha by 3 okay plus A power 5 cos 10 alpha by 5 minus and so on. Okay, so now I already told that if you know the value of S, then we can find the value of C. Now I am going to substitute 2 in 1. Substitute 2 in 1. So please tell, Kavimani, please tell what is after substitution? C equal to what?
The tan inverse of A.
Tan inverse of A. Okay. What is S, yes, sir?
1 minute, sir.
Okay, it's okay.
Yes, sir.
Minus S. What is S?
Minus 1 by 2 tan inverse.
Minus, in bracket, 1 by 2.
Tan inverse of A.
Tan inverse of A. Okay. Minus
1 by 2 of capital A.
Okay, thank you, Parmini. Now, okay, this is nothing but what? Half tan inverse of A1. Half tan inverse of A plus 1 by 2 into A. This is actually C. I call this is 3. Okay. So now I'm going to write A. What is A? A equal to A into cos 2 alpha minus A cube into cos 6 alpha divided by 3. Okay. And then A power 5 cos 10 alpha divided by 5 minus and so on. So now you should, I'm taking B equal to, okay, B equal to A into sin 2 alpha minus A cube by 3 into Purnachandran, why I am taking like this? Can you give any guess?
To eliminate, sir.
I don't get it.
To eliminate terms, sir, A and B.
Okay.
Yeah, to convert cos and sin into tan, sir.
Okay. So I will write one more step, maybe you will get it. Okay, thank you for your giving your suggestion. So A power 5 into sin 10 alpha divided by 5 minus next plus minus and so on. Okay, now A plus IB. Okay, so what is A plus IB? What is the first term? Purnachandran,
A into cos 2 alpha plus
I sin 2 alpha. E power I 2 alpha also.
What is your name? Kavimani. Direct, we can directly write A into E power I 2 alpha. Okay, minus A cube by, thank you, Kavimani. Similarly, you can write what? E power I 6 alpha. Next, A power 5 by 5 cos alpha plus I sin cos 10 alpha plus I sin 10 alpha is what? E power I 10 alpha minus and so on. Okay, so now you can write this is A into E power I 2 alpha minus 1 by 3 A into E power I 2 alpha whole power what? 3. Yeah.
Cube, sir.
3. Yeah, 3. Cube, sir. Yeah.
Plus 1 by 5 A into E power 2 alpha. 2 alpha whole power what? 5 minus and so on. What is this?
Sir, tan inverse of power I 2 alpha.
Yeah, Grigori series. Tan inverse of x. Here x is equal to what? A into e power I 2 alpha. Okay. So this is A plus IB. This is A plus IB. Okay. So now, Uddhavan, are you ready to give the answer for my question now? Okay. Yeah, please tell. Okay. So now the problem is A plus IB equal to, this is related to your question. Okay, I already asked one question in this problem. So that's why you may know the answer for this question. So that's why I'm asking to you. A plus IB equal to tan inverse of A into E power I 2 alpha. Actually, in this problem, a plus ib equal to tan inverse of x plus iy. Okay, va? So what is a and b in this problem? If you know, you can tell, even you can see your notebook and then you can tell the answer.
Sir, we have to write e power I to alpha as cos theta plus I to beta, sir.
No. Again, I'll repeat. A plus, I'll write in the bracket, a plus ib equal to tan inverse of x plus iy. Okay, what? The real and the imaginary part of tan inverse of x plus iy. Okay.
Yes, sir. X is 0 and imaginary part is e power I to
beta. I am asking what is a and what is b. Okay, it's okay. Please check it. I will ask to somebody. Google, if you know, you can tell. Shailaja?
Sir, just a minute.
Yeah, Google. Yeah, please tell. What is A? Samiksha? Priyanka? Yvashri? Yeah, please tell.
Sir, can you see? Sir, A equal to 1 by 2.
1 by 2,
Tan inverse of?
Tan inverse of?
2x by?
2x divided by, okay.
1 minus x square.
1 minus x square minus?
Minus y square.
Yes, correct. Okay, correct. Tell what is, I think we need only A is enough. Okay, va? Okay, I think so. Because I don't need B, okay? So thank you, Yvashri, you are correct. Even I don't need B here, only A is enough. Okay, so now, okay. So from using this idea, from this, what is A? From this equation, what is A? Anybody? 1 by 2, because this is of the form what? This is of the form what? I will write. This is of the form.
Sir, if on the equation எழுதினீங்கல sir, அது வந்து x plus i y னு இருந்தா தான sir. இதுல வந்து e powerல தான sir imaginary part இருக்கு. So அத நம்ம cos theta plus i sin theta மாத்த வேணாமா sir?
பை பை எழுதலாம். உத்தவன் நீ சொல்றது கரெக்ட். எக்ஸாக்ட்டா கரெக்ட். ஓகேவா? நான் அதான் எழுத வந்தா நீ சொல்லிட்ட. ஓகேவா? So இப்போ இது எப்படி எழுதலாம்? e power i theta எப்படி எழுதலாம்? A e power I to alpha is what?
Cos 2 alpha. Cos 2 alpha.
Cos 2 alpha plus?
Plus I sin 2 alpha.
I sin
2 alpha. A I sin 2 alpha. A I sin 2 alpha.
Yeah. Okay. I A sin 2 alpha. Wow. So now this is the form. This is X. This is what? Y. Okay. Wow. Tan inverse of X plus I Y. So A plus I B equal to, in the form of tan inverse of x plus i y, then we have a equal to half tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square minus y square. We know this result already. So using this, now a equal to, please tell, any one of them tell, what is a in our problem? Half tan inverse of
2 into a.
X is what? X is
a to x, a to alpha. A cos 2 alpha.
A cos 2 alpha divided by 1 minus x square is what? A square
cos 2, cos square 2 alpha.
2 alpha. Okay. Y square is what?
A square.
A square.
Cos sin square 2 alpha.
Sin square 2 alpha. Okay. Correct. So this is actually A equal to half tan inverse of, what is the numerator? 2a cos 2 alpha. You can take the denominator, you can take minus a square commonly. So if you take minus a square commonly, remaining thing is cos square 2 alpha plus sin square 2 alpha is 1. So this is your a. But I need what? I need c. So actually I need c. Actually c is what? C is this series. I want to find the sum of this series. You can see in the problem. Okay. So that's why in equation 3, I am going to substitute the value of a. So substitute the value of a. The value of a. N 3. Okay, wa? So what is 3? C equal to, please tell any one of them, half
tan inverse of A.
Tan inverse of A, okay.
Plus half capital plus A.
Half
capital A, sir.
Yeah, this is actually C. Okay, wa? But A is what? A is this value. I'm going to substitute here. So C equal to 1 by 2. Tan inverse of A, and if you multiply by half, you will get what? 1 by 4. Tan inverse of 2A divided, 2A. 2A cos 2 alpha divided by
1 minus,
1 minus A square. So this is the final answer. Okay, thank you everyone. So now you are giving the answer. Okay, so I think you are more interactive than the previous classes. Okay, keep it up. So if you have any doubts, you can ask to me. Otherwise, our time is 3:15. We'll meet tomorrow.